Liberty has a crown with 7 points on it, which represents either the seven continents or the seven seas. Under her left arm, she has a tablet, and on that tablet is the date July 4th, 1776, which marks the Independence Day of the United States of America. And in her right hand, she has a torch, which leads the way into New York Harbour. And Carl and Lisa, I think it's a good thing that she actually has that torch, because with a middle finger of 2.5 metres long, it could have been the international symbol of "you're not very welcome here at all."
Giving it to them, Stevie. That's very funny. And a very, very different statue. Well, most of us were gripped by the Godfather movies in the 80s and 90s, but the mean streets of New York were a long way from Hollywood. The Mafia was and is a very real presence in New York, and for a long time, it was a law unto itself. New York's underbelly. Bloody. Brutal.
I'm going to make him an offer he can't refuse.
A war zone.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today.
And this is where the heads of the family used to come and eat. And they used to sit like over there so that they could see whoever's walking in and out of the place. And God forbid if there was any of, you know, a problem, there was always a back way out.
Vinnie Vella grew up in New York's Little Italy, a breeding ground for mobsters.
You know, they used to wear like black shirts and white ties. And you would walk by them and say, "Hey, what the hell are you looking at?"
The Mafia might have remained the domain of petty criminals if it wasn't for Prohibition. In 1920, alcohol was banned, but Americans still wanted a drink. And for the mob, business boomed. But with power came greed.
And back then, you know, there were all these wars going on, you know, between different families and, you know, so you had to watch out back then what places you went to, who you spoke to, what you see. If you see guys talking, always step away from them.
Known as Cosa Nostra, this thing of ours, the mob bought police and politicians and ruled New York.
Whatever you do, never ask them for a favor, because if you ask them for a favor, then you're going to owe them, and you don't want to owe them. And even beautiful girls keep walking by. That could be a little distracting. But never ask them for a favor.
This is Little Italy today, a haven for tourists from all around the world, probably the biggest attraction being the pizza and gelato. But back in the day, for kids from the wrong side of the tracks, it was all about the money, the women, and the power. The reality, though, was that many of their lives were cut short, shot down by police, rivals, and even friends. It seemed impossible for authorities to get control of the Mafia, but in the end, their greatest weapon would be the Mafia itself.
40, 45, 50, 60,000.
It's gonna be a good summer.
Real life, good fella, Henry Hill was seduced by the glory days of the mob, but faced with a life in jail, he became an FBI informant, one of the biggest rats in mob history.
Could you please point him out for the members of the jury?
50 of his former associates ended up in jail.
I know that I saved a lot of lives because every one of these guys were homicidal maniacs. I mean, you know, and, but it took me many years to forgive myself for what I did.
They're still around somewhere, but you don't know who they are anymore. So, like I said, the less you know, the better.
The Mafia is down, but it isn't beaten, and police know as long as there is money to be made, the mob will exist.
And all in all, we're lucky. I tell myself that every day.
Fantastic on the big screen, isn't it?
Knockout.
And Sopranos. Terrific. And very good gelato down there as well.
All sorted.
And a piece of pizza as well.
You loved it all. Well, now, remember this classic song? Such a beautiful song and such a beautiful message. Well, it was 40 years ago.